back into Caesar's Palace itself now. I think we're just walking back to the room because we are going to Jay Cutler's house tomorrow. Yeah, you heard me right.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
That's a wrap with Jay Cutler. How do you feel?
Ah, mate, Jay. You know what? That was such a cool experience. I hope it all came out well. But yeah, definitely one for the bucket list ticked off.
It was a really good interview. Like, yeah. It went really well. So.
And he spent a lot of time after the interview as well.
Oh, good. We just spoke to him for like half an hour, just chilling.
Olympia talk.
Yeah, crazy. Anyway.
As you do.
Uber's here. Let's get some food. So is that where the Olympia was a few years ago?
When it first came here.
This building on the right? Yeah. How long was it there for?
4 years.
What about me? 5 years?
4 years. 4 years.
Yeah. You've been there, Si, yeah?
Yeah, of course.
Both of you been there?
That was the first Olympia we went to in the lake. I stayed there when I came for my stag do as well.
Bacon.
What have we got there?
Loaded bacon cheesy fries or something. I don't know what they are, but they look and taste phenomenal. The cheese that's on it, unreal.
I am gonna die at the end of
this. Heart attack. Did we get the same thing?
Potato chips on my burger.
Dieting.
This looks class. Look at that. Cheers. Fuck,
it's
hot.
Yeah,
that's nice.
Is that the diet version?
Yeah.
Low fat.
No. Show them your $7 water.
$7 for that, it's not even a big one.
So the woman goes, I asked the woman behind the desk how much a water was. She said $7, and I went, oh, what, the big one? She went, no, the little one. And I went, okay. I'll go without.
So as you can probably tell from the chaos of the videos at the time that I've been here, Vegas was a madness. It was nuts. Today, the following day from what you just seen, so much happened within a week, right? We were there for 7 days. But the following day, we headed out to the Gasp House, which was, I don't actually know where. It was kind of in the middle of nowhere in Vegas. Like, Vegas is a friggin' desert, right? We headed out to the Gasp House, interviewed James Hollinshead and Michael, who is the owner of Gasp and Better Bodies. The documentaries that we're actually there to film will be coming soon. I don't know when. I'm not going to show you too much of the documentaries. Just this little footage of James, because it's jokes, you know?
I can ramble for hours if you wish. I can talk about gaming. Yeah, talk about PCs, graphics cards, anything but bodybuilding.
So this has been the location for today, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Gasp Mansion. 27 bedrooms. Just the one Porsche outside for now. There was another car here earlier, I don't know. It's absolutely huge. We filmed with a couple of people. Michael, who is the owner of Gasp. I think that's his title. He would go down as owner, right? I think so. Anyway, and James Hollinshead, who obviously is competing in a couple of days. But yeah, stay tuned on my TikTok to get a proper look around of this place. It should already be live by the time you guys see this video. But yeah, what a great day. And now we're off back to the hotel because we're going to meet up with Keon. And that's that, isn't it? Yeah?
That's that. What a great day.
Done. Job done. On to the next one.
On to the next Olympian.
On to the next best mate. Alright, so MP3 file for Keon's music. Transfer, I sorted him out with his music for the fucking Olympia. He came to the hotel room, we sorted it out for him, sat down, chilled for 5, and yeah, that's all sorted for him. All the best, Keon, mate. I hope you fucking smash it. Now, I found a place to get my hair cut because it's been a minute. It's been a few days, and that is long enough for me. I'm waiting for my Uber right now, and I think that might be it. Yes, it is. Let's go.
Thank you.
Okay.
Let's go.
Please. Please don't let me down.
Okay. It looks pretty shit to me. I called him literally 20 minutes ago, called him and said I'll be there in 20 minutes.
All right, well now I'm pissed off because that was shut. I literally called him 20 minutes ago saying I'll be there in 20 minutes. I've got a $12 Uber to get there and it's shut. It's shut. They was just sat there like grinning at his TV like, mate. Right, take two. There's another one just down the road, so we're going to see what that one's like.
It's all good, though, because this actually looks a little bit more residential, whereas
where I was a couple minutes ago, even though it's only down the road, to be honest, shit me up a bit, you know? It was almost like it just didn't look great, so maybe it's for the best, eh? Oh, where's this barbershop? It's supposed to be right there, but... what the hell? There's a
sign right there. It says barbershop.
My navigation led me right here. Oh, it's there. Oh, shit.
Now, anyone that remembers the Texas haircut and anyone that knows me just in general knows how funny I am with who cuts my hair. My barbers are sick. And any lad that trusts their barber does not want to go anywhere else. So as they say, it was at this moment. He knew. He fucked up. Oh, did he?
Well, shit. That went so well. I didn't say much, so I kind of sat there all awkward. But the first thing he said to me was, and this is when I knew I could trust him. The first thing he said to me, well, when we were discussing like my house, I just want to fade to walk in. I was like, yeah, cool, come sit down. I was like, okay, I looked around at other people's haircuts. I was like, yeah, I can trust this place. This looks good. And he goes, so a high skin fade, yeah? And I hadn't said anything about how high I wanted the fade or anything about my hair. I was just like, I want to fade. And he knew by how my hair already looked. He was like, you want a high skin fade, right? In that moment, I just relaxed. I was like, yep, you're good, bro. You can cut my hair. Check out Vegas from this side of town. At this time of night, looks fucking awesome. This place is just a really cool place to be, to be honest. It's really fucking cool. I think that's my Uber. Is that my Uber? Yeah. Oh god.
So with the trim finally in check, it's mad, by the way, how much that can do for a guy's confidence. If you get skin fades on a regular basis or on a weekly basis or as often as possible, like I do, let me know in the comments if you agree. So next up, we went to actually see my mate Chris Bumstead, my mate Breon, my mate Keon, all of those kind of people, you know. We had like a massive room or like three rooms full of all the competitors from the Olympia. And this was the time that I met Chris Bumstead. That's the story for next time.
Ladies and gentlemen, the star attraction. Mr. You can't see him. Mr. Chris Bumstead himself. There we go. He's got a queue that goes round the entire fucking place. And this is a big ass room. There's a lot of people in here, hence why I'm sweating. But he's basically got the queue of everyone 10 times over, which is mad. Absolutely fucking mental.
So as you can see, it was not just my mate Chris Bumstead, it was also my best mate, Big Rammy, Mr. Olympia himself. A couple of Mr. Olympias that, you know, they're all my mates. We made good friends in this kind of meet and greet type thing, whatever this was. But that again is a story for next time. Basically, everyone except Keon and Chris Bumstead were sat down because they had the competition so close to this. It was like the following day. We'll focus on that next time. But for today, you have experienced my Las Vegas Spenny haircut interviewing Jay Cutler. And next time, we will see becoming best friends with Chris Bumstead. You ain't nothing but a